Hello, in this video tutorial, I'm going to walk you through the basics of getting started with Google Voice. Now, Gustavus is rolling out Google Voice right now, so not everybody currently has it. But once you get access to Google Voice, there is a couple places that you can navigate to the web interface. One is you can go to voice.google.com and log in with your Gustavus credentials if prompted. Otherwise, from your Gustavus Gusmail window, over on the right, where you have your calendar and your tasks and your contacts, at the very bottom, there's a voice icon. If you click on that, your Google Voice window will display. In the upper right, if you click on Open a New Tab, that will open the Google Voice web interface. So from here, I'm just going to give you a little tour of the window. On the left, you have your main window. This just expands these options on the left. So your options on the left, the first thing is calls. So these are either calls that you made or calls that have come in. So any calls that I have sent out will be in blue. Any calls that I have missed will be in red. And any calls that I accepted will be in green. Below that, I have messages. So this is much like text messaging. I can send a message and text back and forth with somebody through the Google Voice interface. Next up, we have voicemail. So anybody that calls and you miss the phone call will go into your voicemail. If they leave a message, you will see the textual format of that message on the screen, and the play button is down at the bottom for you to play it. Down below that, you have archives, so any messages that you have archived, so much like saving or archiving your mail, and then anything in your spam, any phone calls that would be like spam email. At the very top, you can go ahead and search your Google Voice. So if I want to look up Brianne, I can go ahead and type in Brianne, and I can pull up Brianne's information. From here, I can see all of our past phone calls, and I can message her, or I can go ahead and call her. Over on the right, I have a receiving calls icon here. This is where I can turn on my Do Not Disturb. If I turn on my Do Not Disturb, my web interface will not ring. So this is really nice if you're in a meeting, don't want any interruptions, that kind of thing. But you do need to remember to turn this off. It will automatically set to your availability with your work calendar, which automatically should be set from 8 to 4:45. So this means that it will not ring when it is not within that window of 8 a.m. to 4:45 Monday through Friday. Next up, we have our audio settings. This is important to set up before you receive your first phone call. So if you go into your audio settings and you're going to be using a headset, you're going to want to choose the appropriate microphone and obviously look for the green lights to be displayed. Same thing with ringing, you can go ahead and test that. And there you could hear it coming through my screen. And then my speakers would come through my headset as well if that's what I choose here. So if I'm going to be answering my phone with my headset, I'm going to want to make sure that those two are appropriately set. And then when the phone rings, I can put on my headset and I can answer the phone. Next up, we have a help menu. This is a great place to go if you have any questions about Google Voice. Next up, we have settings, and there are a lot of settings within here. I'll just kind of highlight some of the important ones. So first of all, our account, this is our office phone number, and our emergency services location, which is our address here at Gustavus. Devices are devices that your Google Voice is being used. So you'll have web. You may or may not have a desk phone, depending on if you asked for one. And you may have your own cell phone linked in, which is an option if you want to add it here. Down below that, messages, do you want those text messages to come to an email, yes or no? And then calls, you just have options within here on whether or not they're going to answer calls on the web, on your desk phone. You might have a cell phone linked in within here. And then you can automatically do custom call forwarding messages down below. So you can also get email alerts for missed calls. You can turn that on or off. You can screen calls so you can hear the caller's name when you pick it up. You can show your Google Voice number as caller ID when forwarding calls. And this one's nice is if you'd like to remove all of the call history. So all of the calls that you've made or received, you can go ahead and remove that. It will ask you to verify that and it will clear out all of that history for you. Availability, I mentioned this within the receiving calls and do not disturb. This will follow your Google Calendar 8 a.m. to 4:45 Monday through Friday. So you can choose to follow those working hours or follow to your out of office. So if you set something on your Google Calendar to out of office, it'll automatically make your voicemail here go to do not disturb. One thing you're also going to want to set up is your voicemail. So you're going to want to record a greeting. You can have multiple greetings in here and then select them based on if you're on vacation, if you're out for the day, if you're just gone for a few hours, or just your generic message and you can give it a name. So this is where you can go ahead and record that message. One option here that's nice is get voicemail. This means that you'll be emailed the voicemail and you can actually play it and read it right inside of your email instead of having to come to Google Voice. So those are the main things within here, within your settings. So you'll want to take a look at those. When you're done with the settings, you can just click on the X in the upper left-hand corner. You do have your Google Apps icon. You will notice that the Google Voice icon is not inside of here. So to navigate to Google Voice, you'll have to go to voice.google.com. Highly recommend bookmarking it if that is something that'll be easier for you. And then, of course, you have your face where that is showing your Google account. So a couple ways to make a phone call. You can look up somebody. So if I want to look up Paul Hansen, I can click on Paul here and I can call Paul right from this interface here. Or I can go ahead and type in Paul here. And as soon as I click on Paul here, it will start dialing Paul. So I would have my headset on. I click on Paul. It will dial Paul. And then we could have our conversation. If he doesn't answer, I can go ahead and leave a voicemail. That is one way to call. Another way to call is I can just simply use the numbers down below and go ahead and type in a phone number. I can also use my keypad on my keyboard to put in somebody's number. And I put it in wrong, 933-7179, and it will pull me up. So a lot of different ways to pull up the phone numbers. Now receiving a call, when I receive a call, if I'm in my email, I will get this little, if my window's open, if my Google Voice window's open, it'll pop up in here. If my Google Voice window isn't, it will pop up over on the right-hand side and I can accept or decline. And in my Google Voice, it will show up on the right-hand side and I can either decline or accept it as well. If I decline it, it will still ring for the person calling and it will go into voicemail. And then I'll be able to get that voicemail from my voicemail icon over here on the left. If you do have any questions about the Google Voice interface and how it works, please contact the GTS helpline at 507-933-6000. Thanks so much.